What's up, everyone? Join along for another adventure as we dip into the Pacific Ocean for the first time this year. It was a really fun day, so stay tuned. It's a foggy morning here in Chimanas. Fred took his boat over last night from Richmond, and he stayed at my place. And I met up with Richard and Brett this morning, and we are going to be... Oh, yeah, it's over there. And we're going to be hitting up Porlier Pass. I dove there a few times. It's been a few years. That's actually my first boat dive on Vancouver Island. It's a high current area in between Valdez Island and Galliano. It's a wicked spot, though. I think we got a window to dive it. It's going to be narrow, but we'll get right in that passage and see those walls of anemones. Sometimes there's various life out there, like sea lions and lingcod. But we'll dive that as long as we can, and then maybe hit those bluffs right off Galliano. And if we get time, check out Wallace Island. Wallace Island, one of my favorite spots, and I've never been there in the wintertime, only summer. So this is my first dive since Bermuda. I hurt my back shoveling snow, so I took last weekend off. The visibility is looking pretty sweet here, and we're gonna have an awesome day. Shout out to Fred for always being down for an adventure and bringing his boat along with him too. Well, the sun's not out, but look at the water. You can barely differentiate the ocean from the sky with that fog, but hey, gonna be some nice diving up there. Porlier Pass, super excited. Fred and I planned everything out to the T. Porlier Pass is not a spot for the inexperienced. Some days the slack tide is virtually non-existent. The current will rip in one direction and seconds later the other. You can find up and downwelling currents that can change very quickly. We're right on schedule. Yeah. Hello. My last few dives at Porlier Pass, we only had a 20 minute or so window. It doesn't get much calmer than this. The water looks silky smooth. We really got lucky. Currents in Porlier Pass can reach 11 knots. All the moving water and nutrients is what feeds the vast amount of life in the passage.
Oh yeah, such like this. Oh, it's awesome.
Going from a 7mm suit to a 3.5 is easy. Going back to a 7mm is a different story. Man, did I ever feel buoyant after all my diving in Bermuda. These sheer drop-offs go down to 50 meters. Pretty wild. I don't think I went much past 12 on this day. I'll be honest, diving down a pitch black canyon is a little eerie. Not Bermuda, but there's no arguing the beauty that surrounds BC is incomparable. Cold, dark, and rugged, just the way I like it. Porlier Pass gets hit hard by anglers. I'm wondering if that's the reason we're struggling to see any fish. Oh well, the macro life here on the walls is unreal. Too bad macro filming is not the GoPro's strong point. Anemone Central. Scallop Central too. We did see a couple rockfish and greenling, but overall, not as fishy as one would expect. As we were diving, the current switched directions, and the sediment from the Fraser was pulled up the passage from the Strait of Georgia, and it ruined our visibility. It was a little annoying, as the current was still workable. Oh well, note to self, trying to hit slack at the tail end of a flooding tide. We kept trekking, next stop, Galliano Bluffs. The visibility was looking much better, for now anyways. By the way, I lost a weight belt here in 2019. So if you dive this spot and find it, enjoy your new belt. It's down there 30 meters or so, so you deserve it. Round two. found the rest of that octopus. As Fred was playing around with the juvenile Puget Sound King crab, I found a motherload of some unique-looking bottles. You never know what you're gonna find. This one looks neat.
That one there. Yeah. You guys want one? Grab one. Looks pretty damn old.
What do we got here?
Then there's
whistle.
I'll take that one too. Why not? You guys want it? Or you good?
Chicago.
Is that Chicago?
Yeah, Chicago. The celebrated DDT. Yeah. 1868.
Is that what it says?
That's a pretty small, that's a pretty
18. What? No way.
It's easy when it's like stamped right on it.
Yeah. 1868.
Well, look at the thickness of the blast opening. Like, that's gotta be old.
That's super cool.
I don't need that.
We got the bottle.
Oh, that's awesome.
From there, we cruised up the channel to kill some time at Wallace Island. That's situated between Salt Spring and Galliano. We're at Wallace Island, just a little pit stop. Gonna go cruise around and check out those cabins again. I keep wanting to bring a free dive fin to post up. You know, say we were here, but forget this time again. Maybe next time. The structures on Wallace Island were built by David Conover, the one who discovered Marilyn Monroe. This is the infamous cabin. That's what it means. I want to drop a free dive in here. But so much history. It doesn't smell the greatest. It's like, did a sea lion move in or something? I have a message in the wrong. What do you think? Pretty cool spot?
Super cool spot.
Sweet. Yeah.
Never seen anything like it.
No, man. It's pretty unique.
Fred and Lori had a return ferry back to the mainland scheduled to depart at 5:45. So with a little more time to kill, Brett and I took a peek under the dock. We mostly found some trash, with the exception of a neat bottle or two. Brett found an old milk bottle, and I found what I presumed to be an old jar. I'm not sure what type of nudibranch this was, but it was gorgeous. Eventually, the time had come. But all good, we definitely got our money's worth.
That was a great time out there. Diving Porlier Pass is always awesome. I love that big drop-off with all those anemones. But yeah, we found this little bottle right off Galliano. It looks like somebody's dock there, and underneath it, found a bunch of bottles for that matter, but this is by far the coolest. Liniment, you know, as a boxer, you see, is that, you know, it's kind of like Rob 83535. But some dirty guys, they'd throw that on their boxing mitts, and when they'd punch people, they'd almost go blind due to that liniment sting their eyes. So I think, what is it, Sonny Liston was caught doing that. But yeah, this here, it's just some ointment, so a medicine bottle. It says on the side of it, 1868. I'm not sure if that's when this bottle was made, but let's go with that. Say it's 100 plus years old. Nice old top on there. Anyways, thanks again, everybody, for the diving. That goes to Rich, Brett, and where is he over there? That's Fred over there in his vehicle. Thanks, Fred and Lori. That's sweet, taking your boat out. Oh, there's Fred right there. What's up, man? All right, thanks for watching, everybody. Peace, love, and probably be in the water again next weekend. See you later.